Hello, everybody. This is a 3v3. We are using the Peloponnesian War tournament. The tournament is right now going on. It started a week ago on the Caesars Forum. I think we will do another tournament after this one, and it will be, I think, the Roman Civil War, or like a nomadic factions war, always on DEI. So if you wanna participate this tournament, I will let the link to the group down below in the description. And but for now, this is the tournament. So the rules here are, well, I don't actually remember them. It's roughly one cavalry unit spam. So we can bring one type of cavalry units, and that's all for the cavalry. Then for missiles, sword infantry and spear infantry, the spam limit is 2, and instead for the hoplites, the spam limit is 4. There's no other limit. You can bring how many swords, how many spears, how many cavalry units as you want, as long as it's 1, 2, and 4. The elephants are considered to be cavalry, so as a pirate, I brought one elephant. It's not OP. Might seem OP. It's not OP at all. I will not talk about the tactics yet. This battle is very long, and nothing really happens in the first part, so I'm just talking. And there's also no pikes. We can't bring any pikes. There's no civil war rules, so Massalia can fight against Massalia. We'll find Massalia over here. And this map is one of the maps. Maybe this map can be the next one for the next round. So, you know, I love this map. It's really nice, especially the temple inside this kind of, well, this is a dildo, but yeah, it's fine. All right. So, Zeus is holding a dildo, and let's talk about the tactics. Now, there's no rules about, you know, pushing forward, who has to defend, who has to attack. They have a very nice position here around this temple, and they are of course, you know, using it. Especially for the hoplites, this is so much good, because they have one flank completely covered by the, well, in this case, by the lack of path around the Greek temple on one side, and then on the other side, they have this slope that basically prevents me from moving my cavalry this way, because if I have to charge uphill, I need way much more acceleration that they need to do this way. So I brought a lot of cavalry here, so my idea was, no, I will not attack this side. This is stupid. This is completely pointless. I'm gonna lose all my cavalry. So I'm gonna go around. I'm gonna move all my army all this way, go around and see what they have here, because probably, I mean, we were sure they were trying to hold this area here, because it's, you know, very convenient. I mean, they have one side covered too, and then they have this little forest that can hide cavalry and missiles. So, yeah, I decided to move all this way and try to exploit my cavalry there. Now, it might seem kind of pointless, because it's still a slope, but it's, I don't know, in my opinion, it was less of a slope than this one. So, I moved all this way. They patiently waited for me. I mean, both the enemy and my allies. And oh, by the way, to distinguish the two kinds of Massalia, the little blue Massalia is my ally, and then you will find here the red Massalia is the enemy Massalia. So keep that in mind. I'm still moving all my infantry. I think I actually walk them. Yeah, I think they're walking. My bad, that took another 15 minutes. but yeah, they're still walking, and my cavalry is already here. I'm scouting a little bit ahead because I didn't trust that. Like, in my idea, I thought they would push a little, but instead they just stood in the same deployment area. So like, I don't know. I wanted to be sure that they didn't have anything here, because like, if I'm attacking this area and they have even one unit of cavalry, I mean, this is already a good defensive area. If they have one unit of cavalry here, I'm done. So I wanted to make sure, and I think he's also scouting a little just to try to understand what we were trying to do. I think here they're kind of shooting at each other. Maybe staring at each other. Oh yeah, I think they're shooting this hoplite here, and in a while we will like see that and tell them to shift the phalanx unit this way, to not lose so many hoplites from missiles. And actually, we were fine with this. Like, this is perfectly fine for us. They're wasting ammo on the hoplites instead of our very limited cavalry units, so that was perfect. I mean, other than me, Sparta have two cav units, but I'm pretty sure that Massalia, my ally Massalia, only have one cavalry unit here, and that's pretty much it. Another thing I wanted to say is that we had the best factions, and I mean, honestly, I mean, Massalia against Athens is a safe victory for Massalia. Sparta versus Pergamon, I mean, bringing a Pergamon composition is kind of hard because they have like good and fancy units, but at the same time, these units are ex so expensive that making an actual decent army comp is hard even with this rule. So Pergamon is still kind of weak, and then I had a Pyrrhus versus Massalia. This is, I'm pretty sure, like, this could have been a little bit more even. This fight could have been a little bit more even if I haven't brought if I didn't bring this elephants right here, because they're so expensive. They cost like 4,000 and something, and I could have brought way better infantry, way better cavalry, but I didn't because of the elephants. The elephants are generally good, but not against the op. Like, if they even meet one single hoplite, they will drop to zero en route. So definitely elephants not suggest if there's any hoplites around, and you will see a bunch of hoplites here. This is basically only hoplites. Look at the Athenian hoplites, they're so cool. Anyway, I guess we will see. I'll speed up everything, and or maybe make a cut here, and we will see when we are actually start to engage on both sides, because they will pull out a little here. But yeah, see you later, guys. All right, we are back, and Massalia have finally engaged Athens in this extremely cool, oh my god, this is so cool, hoplite fight, and it's going, I guess, fine for us, is it? Yeah, well, hoplite fights are extremely slow and really boring. Like, they're pretty cool, don't get me wrong. But at the same time, they're so boring. Oh, this guy is dying. You Athenian scum. Dead. I actually love what happens. I hate Sparta. But yeah, that's a dead Athenian soldier right there. On this side, okay, so this is, oh, I completely, this is a mess. I was scouting, then I lost track of what I was doing here, and I was microing something else, And Gio, I think Massalia is brought by Gio, caught my Sarissa Lancers off guard, and I basically lost a unit for absolutely no reason at all. Also, this is not the best game I've ever made, to be completely fair. Like, at the center, you will see, like, a stupid huge mess. My plan here was to just try to absorb his infantry, because his infantry is way better than mine. With my levies here, you can find only levies, basically. Some two warriors, but for the most, it's only levies. Oh, what's going on here? Shooting the cavalry. Ah, good. Good shots on the cavalry. Oh my god, he lost 10 men. That's good. that's perfect, actually. And so, basically, my idea was go through the forest, break everything I find, and then use my cavalry on what is really valuable, which is the hoplites. I can use my cavalry on the hoplites, make a lot of damage, and virtually take no, take no losses at all. So, or even on this hoplites. Here, they're pushing forward. Actually, they're pushing on the flank with both cavalries, with both the generals and the cavalry by Athens and Pergamon. There's not really a lot here. I think Sparta is brought by Nightingale. I think here he started to say, like, oh no, the cavalry is pushing. Oh no, this isn't good. But I think he manages to win this fight too. I mean, they haven't seen this cavalry yet, so they're probably thinking, oh no, they have no cavalry. Which is perfect, because this might be a good ambush here. Oh, now they spotted him. Will he charge, or will he get charged? Probably will get charged. Because, remember, Athens... Oh, yeah. That's a good charge right here. He lost 7 men, he lost more. 13 already, 14. Yeah, he will probably lose this unit here. The cavalry is charging the Spartan youth. The Spartan youth can hold for a fair amount of time. The Pergamon general is going through this gap. This is a good charge here. I think they were afraid of more cavalry reinforcements. But what I would have done here was going all the way here and attack the rear of the Spartan hoplites. On this other side, I'm messing up everything here in the center. I'm fighting some of his swords, but for the most, my cavalry heavy army is doing fine. I'm wrecking through the archers here. I think those are levies, levy archers. Let me talk with the foliage. I'm following this cavalry. Gio is very smart here, because he fall back his cavalry. He knows he's gonna lose this scout fight, also because of my elephants and my missiles. So he fall back all the way behind, and because like this side is completely lost now. There's nothing that can stop my army from swinging. The only thing he can do is beat my very cheap and poor infantry. I'm not even microing them. I'm pretty sure I'm not giving any order here. Oh yeah, they're forming. Probably gave the order to form, but not to charge. This was a very convenient charge if I had, but I didn't. So yeah, I think I haven't shot any of my pulses, or maybe I shot some of them, but not like more than 25% of the ammo. On this side, well, the Spartan cavalry is dying, but again, the Spartan cavalry kind of sucks, so that's fine. The Athenian general is not doing fine. Pergamon's cavalry is destroying everything. Especially the generals doing some very good rear charge. The Helots javelin men will be wrecked in a couple seconds. They will die now. Will they? Doesn't seem like... Oh my god, they took massive casualties. God, this is like 100 casualties in a couple seconds. The Spartan general is running. This is getting kind of framey right now. But as soon as the Spartan general touches the Pergamon's... Oh yeah, he runs. His general is fine now. He's doing fine with his general. Actually... Again, I would have charged the rear, breakthrough. Like this hoplites will die in a charge. You kill these hoplites, and you push and you fall back your general. There's no point in losing the general here. Oh no. Oh, this might be bad. This might be bad. Oh, this is very bad. This is completely bad. Pergamon's general's gone. I mean, maybe he's gone. If this if the Athenian cav goes there in time. Oh, I lost my general here. I lost my elephants here. Again, like, I charged a couple units, and then I met the hoplites, these hoplites here, and I lost all my elephants in a fraction of seconds. So, just doing a good and, like, a very, very good job here at holding me back, because I can't move all my army because of these two units of cav. As long as he keeps these two units, I can't do anything. So, he's doing really, really fine against me here. But I guess over here the fight will be very decisive for Sparta, especially now that he's pulling his general in. And now that the Pergamon general is gonna die, pretty sure Pergamon will crumble in really a couple of seconds. And also I think this one, the balance of power is in my favor because I have a lot of 300 man units left, while they only have 200 men on the hoplites. Yeah. The Massalian hoplites are doing extremely good against the Athenians. I think. Oh, those are Turios, there's not hoplites. Athenian elite hoplites, kind of a waste of money in my opinion. Not because they're not worth it. I mean, they're not worth it. They cost 1,700. They have quality, don't get me wrong. They will probably beat most of the hoplites head on, but overall, they will still lose a lot of men, and they're, you know, just too much expensive. Oh, a little stuttering here. This is a good charge. I'm pretty sure. No, this wasn't a good charge. This was a decent charge. This was actually just a charge. And I'm also shooting. Now I think I'm using all my peltasts. And the Thessalian is doing what the Thessalian can do best, which is charging the infantry. Charging everything. The Thessalian now is good at charging everything. I'm pretty sure I wasn't charging on this. Probably yes, it was. 244 kills for the Thessalians already. What's going on? Oh, the Athenian general fell back. I think he's trying to run from the Massalian general. And this is the ally Massalian general. And I think I should charge this general now. My general is charging on the rear of the Turios. These Turios are slightly better than Massalian Turios. The Tarentine is moving around. I guess I wanted to hit the rear of some unit here. The enemy have some units here, but I don't think they've seen it. And yeah, I mean, on this side, Athens, Sparta have cleared everything. Probably just because of the Spartan general. I mean, this guy, especially when he's fresh, is he's completely unbeatable. So, yeah. Oh, well. Now my cavalry will just wreck everything here. But for the most, they won this fight anyway. So my cavalry is really just collecting kills. It's not really doing anything important at all. Like, Geo did everything right on this fight. And like, the reason why I charged this way was just because I felt like this would have been such a, like, a such a even battle that it wasn't even worth wasting my cavalry on this unit. So I wanted to basically just, like, use their units to crush Geo instead of using my own, because I would have probably either lose it or basically, like, not winning it decisively, which is what you ultimately want. You want to be as efficient as you can. So we had a lot of infantry here, and we still have most of my quality cavalry. I mean, I only lost the levies so far, so I think this was the right move to just charge the rear of these Hoplites to free Sparta and Massalia, and then go back and kill Massalia. Still have my Peltasts. I use my Peltasts extremely, extremely carefully. I only... Oh my god, they're getting wrecked by the Peltasts. Oh, that's terrible. This Massalian Hoplites had the worst fate. Oh my god, one has gotten completely wrecked. Oh jeez. Okay, this is bad. If you're in the middle of this shithole here, you're surrounded and you're getting all those javelins. Oh, crash. Well, game crashed. And then I reloaded and I zoomed in where I was before and crashed again. So I'm not I'm not getting any closer than this. So yeah, the battle is almost over anyway. Sparta is cleaning what's left of Pergamon here, which is just a square formation. Massalia is going for Amylosis. But you made a good job here. He held his general until the very end of the battle. And so, yeah, that a good job there. Let's see the result real quick. So, thanks to all of the the opponents, Nightingale, Astro, Davzilla, which is Loreside on Discord, GOD, and Andre Lemgard. So it was a close victory. It was actually close, like they had a lot of Hoplites left, but in my opinion, having a lot of Hoplites at the end, it's not like winning decisively, so I guess it was way closer than it looked. Let's see, Sparta got double teamed. I think Nightingale did not okay, but just really good, because like he got double teamed, he held them back and he won his side and still managed to make 2,000 kills. So probably he made the best out of the both of us, even if the kills aren't the greatest, but it's still very good. Astro Astro actually helped me a little to hold enemy Massalia back. And that was good, because I really needed help. I mean, he had a lot of infantry, so he could. But yeah, sure. I mean, he still helped me a lot. Then I made the most kills, mostly because of the Tarentine and the Thessalian cavalry. Again, I made these kills on empty missiles. So this is like free and totally useless kills. The rest of my army did decently. My skirmishers, I'm pretty sure I won the fight there just because of the skirmishers. I used them very carefully. I shot only the cavalry or the Hoplites. So I think really the skirmishers are the units I used the best in this whole battle. For the rest, the spears did nothing. The youth did nothing, my levies here did nothing. As you can see, most of my army is levies, except these two Turios. Yeah, I mean, the Ambacto here are still, full life, full health, so basically. these two units are nearly unbreakable. So yeah, let's see the opponents. Lower side with Pergamon. Again, Pergamon is so hard to play with. Still managed to do a great job. His Thorax, I think he wasted a lot of money here on these two units. They're really not worth it at all. For the rest, the Hoplites are really slow. It's weird, these two units of swordmen didn't do many kills, like this zero, like it's weird. Let's see Massalia here. Of course, his cavalry got completely wrecked. I mean, I had the elephants and all of this cavalry in the Thessalians, like, and the skirmishers too, so his cavalry did nothing except his general. This is same fate for the skirmishers. I just ran with my ran them down with my cavalry. For the rest, his army, his infantry made us loader, like his phalanxes did a lot of kills on my levies. Same for the swords. These two swords made managed to make like 600 kills. That's very good. And then Andre with Athens that made the least kills. Of course, he brought only hoplites. So like, I mean, I guess the reason why he brought only hoplites was because he wanted to hold the center, which he kind of did. Like, honestly, the flanks have collapsed faster than the center, so I think he was doing fine. The problem is, of course, with the hoplites, you don't really get to do a lot of kills, so this is completely explainable. The peltasts did good, same. The slinger's probably not worth it, but he had nothing else but hoplites, so... yeah, this is why he didn't make 1,000,000,000,000 kills. Hoplites are really bad, and especially the Athenian hoplites are very, very tough. Athens in general is completely useless in DEI and in Rome. So, great job from the both teams, I think. So yeah, I will probably make another video of this battle, maybe, if it doesn't crash again. And that video will be just the view, the show off from my general point of view, so... Or maybe the Thessalian, I'm not completely sure what I would do, but, yeah, so that you already know what I'm gonna do next. I hope you enjoy those videos. I do enjoy them, because they're really... easy to do. I just put, you know, just press play, record, done. Didn't nothing. So yeah, until next time.